Welcome friends, now we discuss about the penetrance and expressivity. The penetrance and expressivity, these are two words which are associated with our the gene expression. So now we will start with the penetrance. The penetrance states that the percentage of individuals having a particular genotype that expresses the expected phenotype. Now we will explain this by the taking example of a disease known as the diabetes. Suppose there are 100 persons who are having the genes or the genotype of the diabetes. But out of the 100 persons, the 60 persons or 60 individuals are showing the symptoms or are suffering from the disease. Out of 100 individuals, the 40 individuals, they do not show any symptoms or they do not show any disease. Though there have been the gene for the diabetes or the genotype of the diabetes. Now in this case we can say that the diabetes now showing the 60% of the penetrance. So the penetrance implies that the fraction of individual having a particular genotype or gene that develop the symptoms or that develop the character or disease. So now out the penetrance is of two types. Complete penetrance and incomplete penetrance. First come to the complete penetrance. In complete penetrance, all the individual having a particular genotype, all they expresses the phenotype and all they produces the character. Now we will explain this by taking the example of our the Mendel's pea plant. Suppose there are about 100 pea plants having the genotype capital T capital T. Here all are the tall. So the genotype capital T having 100% of penetrance. Similarly, suppose there are about hundreds of pea plants having genotype capital T small t. Here, all the plants having genotype capital T small t, all are tall. So, this genotype having 100% of penetrance. Similarly, we can also explain the case of ABO blood group. And here, the ABO blood group of human having also 100% of penetrance. For example, and all the individual having genotype IA, IB, all have the phenotype AB or the blood group AB. So having 100% of penetrance. Similarly, all the individual having genotype IA, IO, all develop blood group A and having 100% of penetrance. So in 100% of penetrance implies that all the individual having that genotype, having that gene that develop the disease. So now come to our incomplete penetrance. In incomplete penetrance, all the individual having a particular genotype or a gene that do not develop the disease, that do not develop the symptoms or the character. Now we'll explain this by taking the example. For example, the first example is the polydactyl in human. The polydactyl implies that the presence of more than 5 fingers in hand or presence of more than 5 toes. So, the presence of more than 5 fingers or 5 toes is controlled by a dominant allele capital P. So here, the dominant allele capital T responsible for appearance of polydactyly or appearance of more than 5 fingers in our hand. So, the individual having genotype capital P small p, that is a heterozygous, should develop polydactyly because of presence of the capital P. But here, suppose there are 100 persons having the genotype of capital P, small p. Out of the 100 persons, only 70 persons are developing the polydactyly. So, we can say that, and this particular the gene of the polydactyly or this genotype having 70% of penetrance, having no 100% of penetrance. Similarly, another example is retinoblastoma. The retinoblastoma is known as the eye cancer. And if we show that here, retinoblastoma is controlled by the gene RB. Here, the person having two wild copy of the gene or having two normal copy of RBRB gene, which are the normal. But in heterozygous condition, what happened? There is one normal copy of RB gene and one defective copy of RB gene present here. So that, and in this heterozygous individual, for the lifetime, then there is a 90% of chance of this normal gene that become affected. So, and then the 90% of chance having the affectance by the retinoblastoma or the eye cancer. So, here the polydactyl in human and retinoblastoma, they are having the incomplete penetrance. Next come to the expressivity. It speaks that the degree to which a character is expressed is known as the expressivity. In a simple term or in simple way, we can explain that to which extent a character is expressed or a character is developed in an individual is known as the expressivity. As you know that the environmental factor or the environment having so much influence on the gene expressions. So here the change of expression of the gene or expressivity is due to of the environmental influence. Now here we can explain by taking example of the vestigial wings of the Drosophila. So the vestigial wings of Drosophila is controlled by an allelic pair small b small b. So first we understand what is vestigial wing. The vestigial wings means very small wings. The Drosophila having very small wings, they are not able to fly. When you grow the Drosophila under normal temperature condition, they develop vestigial wings. When you grow the Drosophila at a 72 degree Fahrenheit of temperature, they develop slightly longer wings. When you develop Drosophila or when you grow Drosophila at 80 degree Fahrenheit of temperature, they develop more longer wings up to tip of the abdomen. Then from this observation, you can very clearly see that as the temperature become changes, the degree of expression of the genotype small b also keep changing and the degree of expression become increasing. Here this is due to our environmental influence. So the expressivity implies that to which extent our a particular genotype or a particular gene become expressed